Independent Investor Channel. My name is Ryan. I'm going to give you some insight about some of the stock moves that I've made, both on the active side of the house, the stock purchases that I've made here in the month of March. Obviously, you can see that I've reintroduced some capital back into the market. I've scaled into some of these positions. I've given you the share base of these stocks. I'm going to go through them rapid fire. I'm not going to back up the research that I did in making these stock picks. But what I will do is re-emphasize the importance of making sure that you're doing your own research, all right? There are no two portfolios the same out there. And it's very, very important that you understand that this is just an insight on how I seek my exposure to the stock market. Now, these purchases have taken place over the last week. These purchases are in addition to an already existing mature portfolio, all right? Now, this has been built up over many, many years, but the proof is in the pudding, all right? This is not a three-stock pick. This is obviously a nice array of single stock. You guys have probably heard of most, if not all, of these names. Certainly look into it. Do your research. You can do the math yourself to see actually how much money I've got here that I've introduced into the stock market. So let's get right on it. I'm going to be rolling it out here in relation to the two stock accounts that were funded in with these purchases. Both of them self-directed Roth IRA accounts. Niche of the channel. If you don't know what that is and you're new to the channel, I would certainly want you to bring yourself up to speed and understand the benefits of investing passively into good quality stocks, passive ETFs in a self-directed account. We almost drastically reduce, if not eliminate in most cases, the fees within those accounts. Guys, first time to the channel, make sure you're subscribing to the channel. Very, very important that you're getting this empowering message. All right, let's jump right into it, man. AMT, 10 shares added to my existing position in American Tower. This is the only single stock REIT that I do own as a single stock offering. Most of the stock picks you're going to see on the board here, if not all of them, do in fact pay a dividend. There may be a couple on here that don't. Some of the Chinese names that I'm going to get to obviously do not. They're more in the growth category, but added to my shares in AMT, really my favorite REIT out there. I'm glad to own it. Owned it for now a couple years, and this is an additional 10 shares to my existing position. Second, Boeing. Ticker symbol BA, added 5 shares into it. We'll be setting all of these stocks that are purchased up on dividend reinvestment within the self-directed account. Boeing, 5 shares, pretty self-explanatory on Boeing, all right, in the industrial sector. Alibaba and Baidu added 10 shares of Alibaba. Alibaba's been on a tear, still from a valuation perspective looking good. Same with Baidu, probably better valued than Alibaba at this point, to be honest with you, but decided to take a crack at both of these fine companies. 15 shares of Baidu, 10 shares of Alibaba, respectively. All right. FedEx and the industrials added 10 shares as a base position. A lot of these are entry-level positions, all right, but not bad for a self-directed investor, right? Don't need to seek out help from a financial planner. This is all done on my own with a little bit of research and a little bit of wherewithal. This is something that anybody can do, all right? It doesn't take a genius to know that FedEx is a good company worth investing in over the long term, all right? FedEx, 10 shares. Another fine retailer, probably one of the best retailers on the market, is Home Depot, all right? We added shares in Home Depot, 10 shares, again, a starter position. We felt like it just came way, way too far off of its 52-week range. Looking at it here, very, very good entry point here, 10 shares in Home Depot. Coca-Cola Classic, KO. Got abused on its last quarter, went down into the low 40s, picked it up here, a 50-share position in Coca-Cola. Dividend aristocrat, give me some dividend income in the portfolio. No-brainer to pick up and complement my existing holdings already in PepsiCo. Decided to go ahead and pick up Coca-Cola in account number one to complement that and add some dividend value in the portfolio here with Coca-Cola. Lockheed Martin, 5 shares of Lockheed Martin in account number one. Great defense sector, wonderful company. I've owned it before, made some good money. Lockheed Martin has just been on a tear. Next one in the insurance is Prudential, PRU, the ticker symbol, added 15 shares. This was probably the best value of the list. Quite frankly, both of the insurers that I picked up on a valuation perspective were probably the most attractive along with the Chinese stocks here. So very good valuation here on Prudential, trading less than 10 times forward on Prudential. All right, PayPal in the payment space. Again, a complementary trade, that of which I hold Visa in the other account, right? So I wanted more exposure to the payment space. PayPal allowed me to get that growth side of the house exposure, 25 shares in PayPal. And finally, Stars Constellation Brands, we added 15 shares. I owned it already last month. I sold it for a nice profit. It paid the dividend. The dividend is still in the portfolio, and I added back the share position again. So that'll complement my existing partial shares in it. Stars Constellation Brands. Very, very good spirits provider. Love their suite of products that they offer. Glad to own this 15 share starter position. The remaining holdings here we've got, we entered into some sector spider ETFs. Again, some starting positions to kind of monitor and increase my allocation within the portfolio. VWO is the emerging markets. This was an existing position that I had. I had sold it when it had run up very well. It's adjusted back. I've added 4 shares to an existing 20 share position for a little over 60 shares of the VWO in the emerging markets, which I feel is probably the best value right now globally, emerging markets. All right. VHT is the healthcare sector spider ETF, 15 shares there. Financials added 20 shares here. And VNQ was an interesting addition to the portfolio. I've actually never owned it before, but VNQ allowed me to get exposure to the real estate REIT spider ETF offered by Vanguard, traded under the ticker symbol VNQ. Pick up 20 shares. That rounds out account number one. Rolling right into account number two, Costco. Probably my favorite one of the list, 15 shares here. That's a no-brainer. Costco is going to be in the portfolio paying a smaller dividend, but just really one of the greatest retail stocks out there. Well-run company along with Home Depot. It's really two of my favorite managed companies right now. And that'll continue to be a staple in this portfolio over here. Costco, 15 shares. Cisco, 50 shares to add some dividend income, some exposure here more. I needed to beef up the allocation to the technology sector. Cisco helped me round that out and pick up some dividend income to boot. Emerson Electric in the industrial sector, 30 shares there. General Dynamic, again, with the defense. Subsector here in industrials, picked up 10 shares of General Dynamics. Honeywell, same idea, 10 shares of Honeywell. Lowe's to complement Home Depot, really doesn't get any better in the home improvement space. Now we own both of the big behemoths, Lowe's and Home Depot. Fantastic pickup. MetLife on the insurer side of the house, AIG was the third one that I did not buy, but all three of those on a valuation perspective looked very, very good. Decided to go with MetLife, 30 shares there. Altria, MO, 30 shares, picked up some killer dividend income. Got a very, very attractive technical read on the chart for Altria, so we decided to pick up 30 shares there. Novartis in the healthcare sector, 20 shares. Raytheon, one of the very, very best defensive sector. Now we really own all the premier defensive subsectors in industrials. You can't argue with the LMT, Raytheon, General Dynamics, with my existing holding in Northrop Grumman. They really complement each other. Now we really own all the good ones. And finally, a nice starting base position in VTI, the total market ETF from Vanguard. We picked up 50 shares in account number two, guys. So introduced a broad range of exposure to the stock market here in March of 2019. I really hope you appreciate this. The proof is in the pudding here. This is not three stock picks of the month. This is serious. This is exactly the number of shares that I bought. You guys can do the math on it if you're interested. You guys can save it to a watch list and see how it performs going into the future, guys. First time to the channel, make sure that you subscribe. Hit that subscribe button, hit the thumbs up if you enjoy this message. Leave your comments at the bottom, any stock picks that you're picking up in the meantime. And we do put on a live stream every Friday, 9 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. Come in, give us your ideas. Let's talk stock, man. It's my favorite topic, and we're trying to get folks excited about the prospects of getting started in the stock market for your own. Remember the solutions that we also roll out on the Independent Investor Channel. You can seek out your exposure both passively with your M1 finance option, and you can expect to get your stock exposure on the active side of the house using the first trade option, both of which the Independent Investor Channel is affiliated with. The links are in the description below. Click the links, click over, check out the platforms for yourself, guys. And as always, good luck in your investment future.